Hello, everybody. It is 3:11 p.m. Central Time on Sunday, October 9th, 2016, and I'm jumping on here to do a quick update and emergency alert for my West Coast viewers. In case you aren't aware, a swarm of earthquakes has broken out off the coast of Oregon, directly inside of our warned area, and hitting the magnitude range we were expecting, a 4.9, 4.2, and 4.1 struck consecutively over the past few hours this morning going into this afternoon, West Coast time. So, if you guys go back just a few days, over the past 2 to 3 days, we warned the northwest coast of California off the coast of Oregon, right east of the cleft segment, and the cleft segment is at this triangular bend just to the west of the swarm of earthquakes. And I'm going to open up a screen capture for you guys to take a look and see what I'm looking at here so we can go look it up on Google Earth and show you guys what's there. This is the forecast area that we were looking for to be hit. There is no doubt about that. And let me get this display capture turned on. This is on the live stream, keep in mind, so I'm doing this all live. And here we are, all right. And we're going to take a look again at the earthquakes here. There's the location off the coast of Oregon, 4.9. Now we forecast a 5 to 5.2, but if you take a 4.9, add in a 4.2 and 4.1 plus other smaller earthquakes, that adds up to a 5.1, 5.2. All right, so here's the coordinates for the earthquake itself. See, it says off the coast of Oregon. Could they be any less specific about the location? All right, so we'll put the coordinates in. And keep in mind one more time, guys, you had a 2 to 3 day warning for this to strike, and it struck exactly in the location we were watching for. So here we are. See this? It says East Blanco Depression. And back this out just a little bit more, and you can see the cleft segment. All right, these are undersea volcanic fields, and there's tens of thousands of volcanoes that make up this location. And when I say tens of thousands, literally thousands of undersea cones, this imagery really doesn't do it as much justice as it should, but you can see all the small little cone seamounts here. Every single one of those is a different eruptive location. And as we get further to the west, at East Blanco Depression, we'll zoom in a little more and you'll see it's very impressive. So, this is the spot that was warned. This is the spot that was struck. You had a 2.5 to 3 day warning for this 5.0 range activity to strike. It may not be done yet. We may see the swarm carry on, but I can tell you this, the areas to the east and southeast now need to be on watch for a noteworthy increase in activity. And this includes the people in the Midwest, in Oklahoma, Kansas, going south into Texas near Dallas. Why do I say that? Well, the pressure always transfers to the east and it hits the pumping operations at these locations. There is one more spot up here in the northwest, right next to Yellowstone. So there is another spot for another swarm to break out. It won't be as large as the five over here to the west, maybe just a little bit less. So we really have two spots to watch, but the more populated location is down here in the Midwest, going down towards Dallas and up into central Kansas. All three states should be hit in the next day to 2 days, possibly three at the most, but I'm more leaning towards 1 to 2 days. Transfer to the east. Every time we see activity on the west coast like this, it presses to the east. So be aware that's going down now, guys. Go check my channel, which I will also link down below in this video as I save it on YouTube once I'm done updating here on the live stream. You'll be able to go see the multiple days warnings that was issued for this location. And hear me explain why. If you tuned in last night at 10 p.m., you already knew to watch this spot, correct? So you shouldn't be shocked if you were here last night. If you're a new viewer or a viewer on the West Coast, we forecast earthquakes on a weekly basis, sometimes semi-weekly, and we usually nail it by up to 85% accuracy computed by other people who have been keeping track, not just myself, so you don't have to take my word for it. Other locations around the planet we're watching include Italy, over in Japan, down here in Papua New Guinea, which was just struck by 5.8, and again, off the coast is now been struck. Much love to everybody who's been involved with getting the word out. I'd like to take the panic away from earthquakes. And the way do we do that is we forecast earthquakes a couple days out, so people have plenty of time to prepare. We got very lucky on the West Coast today. Like I said, if it was 100 to 200 miles off, it would strike over on land. And if it struck over on land, then that could cause some noteworthy damage in people's houses and to the exteriors of their house, whether it's a brick facade, concrete facade, can get serious damage in a 5.0 range earthquake. So we don't like to gamble on this kind of stuff, so have a plan, be prepared just in case, guys.